is what our scalp looks like right now. Hey loves, welcome back to my channel. My name is Adanna, and if it's your first time stopping by, hello boo. So today we are going to take you all through how I'm going to revive, refresh and moisturize this knotless box braid. I've kept this in right now for about 2 weeks and a half, so as you can see, it's not really fresh, but I want it to be fresh again. So I'm going to take you all through how I'm going to refresh this entire hairstyle. I want to keep this hairstyle for another 1 week, about 1 week and a half. We'll see how it goes. But if you want to see how you can refresh, revive and moisturize your knotless box braids and your regular box braids, then please keep on watching. And without further ado, let's get started. Yo, this hairstyle is one beautiful, flawless hairstyle because it feels so lightweight on your scalp. You don't feel like anything is pulling. But on the other hand, it gets quite frizzy pretty fast, especially if you do have natural hair. Yeah. Yeah, it does a lot. Okay, so this is what our scalp looks like right now. Look at that. This is what it looks like at 2 weeks and a half old. But as you can see, I don't really have that much build up. As I previously mentioned, this is one hairstyle that easily gets frizzy. I'm going to try to make sure that while we're doing this entire refreshing and reviving process, we're not going to, you know, expedite the entire freezing process. We're going to make sure that we are reducing as much, or is it avoiding? What is the English I'm looking for? So, avoiding as much frizz as possible during this entire reviving and refreshing process. What I'm going to do right now is to grab a cutting round, just a regular cutting round, and your water bottle, and I'll just spray some water on this, get it very wet, and then I'll just go ahead to start, you know, cleaning my scalp, like the lines of my scalp right there. As I said, I don't really have that much build up, so I don't really have anything much to clean off. I'll just focus more on taking away all of that edge control. Just want to make sure that you're being as gentle as possible. The reason why I'm using a cutting round is because the cutting round, the surface is very smooth, so it doesn't really, like, you know, it doesn't make your hair to be all over the place. You could use a towel to also do this exact same thing, but you also want to make sure that the towel that you're using has a smooth surface, just so you're able to focus on the lines and the places that you're cleaning, and make sure that you're going in the direction of where the rest of your natural hair is going. Just like this one, for example, you can see that I'm trying to wipe off as much, you know, hair gel and product that's here, so I'm just wiping it off in the direction of my braids. And to clean off any form of build-ups that you may have on the root of each strand, you could just grab a strand of hair that you're cutting round that's damp with water, and then just do this. Touch it right there. There you go. Okay, so as you all can see right now, our scalp looks pretty clean. This is all we're going to be doing for the entire cleansing. The entire cleansing process. And then to moisturize this hair, what we're going to do right now is grab your spray bottle of water. So this is my spray bottle of water right here, with just a tiny bit of water in here. Okay, just a little bit. And I'm going to take some of my favorite leave-in conditioner. This is the Kinky Curly Knots Today, this one. This is a great conditioner if you do have low porosity hair, and I also love the fact that this conditioner is lightweight, so it's perfect for, you know, if you have box braids or all whatnot, just so you don't want to have any heavy products added to your hair. We're trying to avoid as much product build-ups, so we're sticking with lightweight products. You go ahead to put in this leave-in conditioner just on your palms, like you go ahead to put it on your palms and use it on your hair just like that in its raw state, but I want to be able to avoid as much frizz as possible, so I'm going to put that in a spray bottle of water just so it's easier for us to just, you know, spray on our hair and just massage it in without doing you get what I mean. So this is our leave-in conditioner with our water in here, and I'm going to go ahead and add a bit, just a tiny bit of tea tree oil. You could use tea tree oil or peppermint oil, any essential oil basically that targets dry scalp, flaky scalp, dandruff. It's going to help with itching, it's going to help to soothe your hair. Just about 3 drops, yeah, that's good. And then we can shake this. There are also like leave-in conditioner sprays that are actually sold at the beauty supply store. So if you don't want to have to mix your own, you can go ahead to purchase like a leave-in conditioner spray. It basically works the exact same. But this is our own DIY leave-in conditioner spray. Right now, we'll just take what we have in this bottle right now. Then we'll just start spraying this all over the roots of our braids right there. And then you can just, you know, tap in just like so. So in this bottle right now, you get both your hydration from the water and you also get your moisture from the entire leave-in conditioner as well as your tea tree oil. And I want to also make sure that you're coating the body of your braids, especially where you know your natural hair is, like this area. I know my natural hair is laying down in this section, so you want to make sure you're coating that with all of this juice. Alright, just tap this in. It's our hair, just like so. Okay, and then for our scalp, you want to make sure that you're oiling your scalp when you have braids. And I'll be sticking with something lightweight, like I said, you don't want to have build-ups, so you're trying to minimize or build-ups, any of those stuff. So we're sticking with lightweight products. And I'll be using this sweet almond oil, this one. So this is 100% pure almond oil. I'm just going to use this right now to oil my scalp. All of that juiciness you need for your scalp, this is where you're going to get it from right now. Oil every single layer, every single line. Don't skip any parts. Just use the tip, the knob of your fingers, and just press this into your scalp. Just so you can make sure that all of that oil is getting into the right places. Alright, so now that we're done with this entire moisturizing process, we're going to go ahead to tie this down. I'm going to tie it down for about 30 minutes to 1 hour. This is going to help to allow all of that moisture to absorb into our hair, you know, everything just getting into the right places. We're going to tie it down. The warmth also is going to help these products to even work a lot faster. Okay, so I'm going to tie this. At this point, we're going to leave this hair right down to dry. We'll be back in the next 30 minutes to 1 hour. Once it's all dry and all of that product has fully absorbed as much as possible, we'll be back to do the entire refreshing process. Welcome back, Chocolate Principal. Yo, so I went ahead to finish up my makeup. It's been a little bit over 1 hour right now. Ooh, my hair already looks pretty fresh. All right, so now it's time for the real work. I'm going to use an elastic band right now to hold these braids together. I have 40 strands of braids, and of course I'm not going to go ahead and start with every single of the 40. I'm just going to do the first two lines, and that should be okay. Just need a little refresher, not anything too much. Okay, so this is the very first strand of braid that we're going to be working on. You just have to grab your braiding gel. I'm using my Shine and Jam gel, this one. Honestly, there's no difference between the red Shine and Jam gel and the yellow one. At least I haven't noticed any difference. I feel like they both work the same. So I basically just pick up the one that's available at the beauty supply store. I tend to get a few questions from y'all asking me if there's a difference between the red Shine and Jam and the yellow one. I don't think I've noticed it. Okay, so we'll grab this strand of braid right now. We'll apply the Shine and Jam gel to the root of our natural hair right there. Okay. Like this. This is not something that you do every day. This is more like what you do once in 2 weeks or once in 3 weeks. This is not an everyday routine for sure, because you don't want to have build-ups. We're going to go ahead to use our parting comb right there. Okay, to just make sure that the parting is quite significant. Like the original parting is as significant as it was when the hair was fresh. Apply this gel. Okay. And then you grab your edge brush. Brush it right there. Two. Do this for the back. And then you take this braid right now. While grasping your natural hair into it, you just twist it around. Twist it. Twist it. So once you have that all twisted, then you grab your little hair clip. This is the one we're using, this tiny one. Right there at the root of our hair, you just got to secure that. So that by the time we come back to it, it's all dried and it just stay that way. We're just going right now to repeat the exact same process This is a new strand of braid. Grab your Shine and Jam gel or any braiding gel of your choice, but I prefer to stick with the Shine and Jam gel because it doesn't flake, it just dissolves into your hair even when it starts to get old. So that's why I like to stick with Shine and Jam gel for braiding. And I'll just apply this right here. Alright. Then once you're done twisting this, then we just secure it right there. Okay. Good, 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 good. Alright, so the next one. Next one. Okay, see what we've done. We've done this for right now. Look at how clean and neat that looks. My patterns are beginning to pop as they should. Voila, we are basically done. So this is basically all I'm going to do right now. I know I look like as if I'm going to the wall with all these pins going on here, but we're going to leave this to sit for another 30 minutes for it to dry a little bit. Yo, I actually forgot something. So we're going to go ahead right now to use the Style Factor Edge Booster Pomade. This one, okay. I'm going to use this just for the front, you know, for my edges in front, just because the Shine and Jam gel doesn't really give that kind of hold that I want for my edges. It's not giving it as strong as kind of strength I'm looking for right now. It's not really going to do that for me for the edges. So I'm just going to use the Star Factor Edge Booster Gel, a little bit of that, just over top of my edges in front. So I tried to use just a little bit of the Star Factor Edge Booster Pomade, just because this product actually turns white. In as much as it has a good hold, it does turn white. It gives me flaky whiteness, which we're not trying to go for. So just a little bit to give my edges that extra oomph of a hold. Now we can go ahead to tie this hair down. Don't tie it too tight, though. Remember, you have clips on your head, so you don't want to hurt yourself. This is what our hair looks like right now. Okay, baby girl, come on. Yo, I just left the hair salon. I mean, as you can see clearly, I just left the hair salon right now as I'm just coming back. Wow, 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 wow. Okay, all right. So we just go ahead and start taking off these clips one by one. Okay, gently take it off. Take your time. Don't be in a hurry. There you go. Take this off. Okay, Sesak. So now that we're done taking off all of those clips, and you can see our hair is already looking quite, you know, look at our pattern now. Pattern is now where it's supposed to be staying. It's coming out. It's looking pretty good. We're going to go ahead right now to use this foam setting mousse. This is from African Pride. Yo, this hair mousse smells so nice. It literally smells like candy. So you just get a little bit of this on your palms. Take this and then set this into our braids. This is going to help to lay down any flyaways that we have on the body of our braids. It smells so good. Oh. And then the last thing we're going to use right now is the braid sheen spray. This is from African Pride as well. This is just going to add that sheen to your braids. So I'll just go ahead right now to tie down this scarf. Okay, and I'm going to leave this on up until we're ready to leave the house. This will just give our hair more time for it to dry and for our edges to also lay down perfectly. Wow! Wow, wow, wow! Hey! Yo, 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 no, come on, look at this hair, look at this hair, look at this hair. Can you see how everything is just looking very neat, flat, nice? The patterns are patting, everything is popping, it's just striking where it's supposed to be striking. Look at that. See, I just got fresh braids. Like, I mean, who is going to say I didn't get fresh braids? Can you not see? you not see though? But yeah, this is basically the end of this video. This is how I refresh my box braids, my knotless braids specifically. And let me know down below in the comment section if you've tried out these knotless braids. And when you tried it out, how are you able to maintain yours, revive yours, and all of that good stuff. Of course, we like to learn on this channel, so I'm sure your own idea would also help all of us. And yeah, that's basically it. I'll see you all in my next video. Oh wow, this hair looks so good. This hair will literally last me for another 1 to 2 weeks. Like, look at that. See how fresh and clean it looks. Asampete. But that's the thing for this video, y'all. I hope you all enjoyed it. Thumbs up if you did, comment, share, subscribe, and I will see you all in my next one. Have a lovely rest of your day. Bye. This one is plenty kisses to be blown. Bye bye. Kilo me, 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 kilo